Welcome to the umpteen kingdoms of Easter Egg. Begin your journey by wresting control of a noble family. Each player takes 5 character cards with matching sigils in the upper left and right corners of the card. As your nobles seek the porcelain throne, you'll plague them with horrible mishaps that lower their self-worth. The lowest scoring, most tragedy-afflicted family wins. To begin play, shuffle the rest of the deck. Each player draws 5 cards. Gloom of Thrones uses transparent cards, allowing multiple cards to be visible even when stacked on top of each other. On your turn, you will play 2 cards, and then draw back to your draw limit, which is 5 cards unless it's been altered by card effects. An event card has a single-use effect listed at the bottom of the card. It is immediately resolved, and the event card is then discarded. Here, the King's Caravan cometh, forcing all other players to discard cards with the Goblet Story icon. Modifier cards are played on top of any character on the table, yours or another player's. The special effect of a modifier card listed at the bottom of the card takes immediate effect and applies to the person who controls the character the modifier was played on, not necessarily the one who played the card. Kelly C. was a little too busy making sure her 3rd hair braid didn't clash with the other 2, and she let herself be manipulated by a Meister. The player to her player's left may now randomly select and discard 2 cards from her player's hand. Modifiers also have self-worth scores listed in 3 locations on the left side of the card. The character's current self-worth is equal to all of the visible scores. It's important to only pay attention to what you can currently see. For example, only visible self-worth scores which have not been covered by higher cards are used when determining a character's self-worth. The Meister manipulated Kelly into marrying a monster, which has definitely done irreparable damage to Kelly's chill. Some modifiers also have story icons, which may trigger special effects in conjunction with other cards or allow certain cards to be played. As Kelly C. declares herself a strong, liberated woman, files for divorce, and starts meddling with the monarchy, for example, she has gained a crown icon. This special icon means that she has seized the porcelain throne. Seizing the porcelain throne and becoming the monarch happens automatically whenever a crown icon is played on a character. Heavy is the head that wears the crown, however, and the throne is worth -30 self-worth. If the monarch dies before the end of the game, they lose the throne, which returns to the center of the table, and the self-worth. And how shall death come for them and for all others? When an untimely death card is played upon them. Untimely death can only be the first card you play during your turn, not the second, unless one of your characters is currently the monarch. Untimely death can also only be played on characters who currently have a negative self-worth score. Kelly C. drank herself to death, and so the porcelain throne was lost. The game ends when the last member of one of the noble families joins their kin in the sweet embrace of death. That is when all of them have had untimely deaths played on them. Each player totals the self-worth scores of only their dead characters, plus the -30 self-worth from the porcelain throne, assuming a living character still sits upon it, or if the monarch's death triggered the end of the game. The player with the lowest total self-worth wins the game. When you play the Gloom of Thrones, you win when you die, and there's always another story to be